What is a state funeral?
A state funeral is the highest form and the most ceremonial form of funeral in Jamaica and in most countries, and the term is international. It's accorded to a limited number of potential people who have died recently, very often heads of state only and that sort of thing. In Jamaica, for governors general, prime ministers, former governors general, former prime ministers, they don't have to die in office. And then the cabinet, the regulations allow the cabinet to determine other people or another person if the cabinet so wishes, and presumably sort of goes to a cabinet vote.
What is the difference between a state funeral and an official funeral?
Official funerals you come across reasonably often. I mean, you know, sort of maybe one a year or one every 2 years or so. This is at a slightly, dare I say, lower level. A cabinet minister is entitled to an official funeral, and various other people at that sort of level. Certainly, I would think the leader of the opposition or a previous leader of the opposition would be given an official funeral. The most outwardly visible difference is that state funerals are coordinated by the military, by the Jamaica Defense Force, and official funerals by the Jamaica Constabulary Force. And accordingly, people like members of the bearer party and escorts and so on are from those two respective organizations. Now, in a state funeral, you will find the police playing more of a role than certainly the army would be playing in an official funeral. For instance, the gun carriage, and we'll come to that probably if you were to ask about it later, on the procession, the cortege that moves from the church, in this case the Roman Catholic Cathedral on North Street, to the National Heroes Park and the cenotaph site. Now, there it's escorted in advance by horse outriders from the JCF, because the military don't have trained horses and so on. So you'll get a formal police role with them in their full dress uniform, you know, white tunics with stand collars, but the main emphasis visibly will be on military personnel, and it is entirely the Jamaica Defense Force.
What is involved in the planning of a state funeral?
You need to have rehearsals, and I remember I was officially working with the JDF on Hugh Shearer's funeral, and our rehearsals, I think if I remember rightly, started at 3 o'clock in the morning to avoid messing traffic up. And my role was to check the sort of deportment and so on of that horse outrider party, and also the streetliners, because you have to have that funeral, if I remember rightly, they were all cadets, I think, JCCF, Jamaica Combined Cadet Force personnel, the whole way from the cathedral up to the park. I believe on this occasion it will be a mixture of military personnel, soldiers, possibly sailors from the Coast Guard, but certainly soldiers and cadets.
What is a lying in state?
Now, we use that term very sloppily in Jamaica. All sorts of people lie in state when in fact they don't. The term is, other than for a state funeral, the body will lie, or the deceased will lie at, not in state. In state, as a phrase, should only be used for a state funeral. And that lying in state involves sentries, posted officers, not other ranks, at each corner of the coffin, which we tend wrongly to call caskets, by the way. And so you find that there's a ceremony, a ceremonial aspect to the lying in state. It's not just that the coffin is there and people can file by, which you are allowed to do, but it's in a sense ceremonially guarded by commissioned officers. The public may file past the coffin during a lying in state, and that is not restricted. It's guided by police and ultimately the military. Then you have the funeral service, the actual church service with hymns and prayers and so on. And the access to the cathedral is clearly essentially limited because of space. They may well, I don't know the arrangement, I'm not involved on this occasion in the actual makeup team, but it's frequent in such cases that they'll have a big marquee, a tent outside the church premises, or in the premises but outside the church building, and with good television coverage, large screens, so that people who would like to come in can sit there. There must be some degree, obviously, of rationing of seats, pew positions, and so on, because all the official people have to have their places up front in front pews. Don't forget, people that we might normally think of, the diplomatic corps will be represented in considerable number. So clearly, Mr. John Public, Mr. John Public can't just come in and go wherever they'd like. But access to some degree is usual, even in the church service. And then after that, it's very easy, just line the route.
For state funerals, the mode of transportation is traditionally a gun carriage. What is a gun carriage?
That's an interesting residue of, the 19th century. Field artillery, is a term which is used to describe guns which can be used in the battlefield and therefore essentially have to be movable. And so they have wheels. And as the field artillery concept developed, instead of just having the old-fashioned cannon with a couple of wheels on either side of it sort of thing, a carriage was developed once you had breech-loading artillery. And the gun is fixed to the carriage, but it can be removed. And so what is done here is that if a gun happened to be attached to a carriage and they wanted to use it, it would be removed and the coffin placed on the gun carriage instead. Nowadays, field artillery is of a much more advanced nature, and it doesn't have carriages in that old-fashioned sense. And so the only gun carriages in the traditional sense that there are for state funerals, and many countries have a limited number of them. We have one, I think, without being absolutely certain, that ours is a World War I vintage gun carriage. I know that the Jamaica Defense Force take great pains and care every time it's needed to, make sure that everything works properly, and if it needs a little sort of tightening up and polishing and so on, it's all done. So it's in marvelous condition, but it's a very old, if I can call it a vehicle at all, with wooden spoked wheels and so on. Quite interesting to see.